Today's video is sponsored by Squarespace. Okay, I think this is an okay angle. I always feel so weird in front of a camera, I'm so sorry. Hi guys, I am going to be doing a stationery haul today. Everything that I've gotten is like right here on this desk. I have like a huge table set up with everything that I'm gonna go for: journals, paper, painting supplies. I've gotten a bunch of pens, washi tape, and some like random little tools and knickknacks. I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get into it. I'm so awkward. All right, let's go. All right, so the first thing that I wanted to show you guys is something pretty exciting. Amanda Rach Lee sent me one of her new dotted notebooks and it's so cute. I'm actually debating whether I should give this one to my sister because she loves the color blue. She has like a taupe colored one that I think that I would really like. I love that a bunch of like artists and journal people are coming out with their own journals. It's so cool. But yeah, the front page has a cute little pattern. She has a flap in the back if you want to store stuff. So I have the Archer and Olive journal and it looks like they both have 160 pages and they both are 160 GSM. So it should be fairly similar, but we are going to try out some paints in them later and some pens and see how it works out. She also came out with washi tapes that she sent me, so I'll be showing you guys those in a little bit too. So that was the only journal I got recently, so now we're going to move on to paper. So I have a few different exciting things that I've gotten. So these ones are from Kelsey Pike Paper Crafts. I love that they come in like a variety of different colors. This one is like my all-time favorite. It's like a blush kind of cream color. I happen to snag a like random assortment pack and all of them have like deckled edges, which I love. But I think I'm gonna do a bit of like art and stamping on these since I've been making rubber stamps lately. The other handmade paper that I got, which I'm really excited about, and I kind of spent a good amount of money getting these because I knew I wanted to do a bunch of projects with them. But these ones are from Idle Paper. I think a lot of people use these for like their wedding invitations. They're very fancy and they have like the most amazing colors. I think the ones that I got are white sand, blush, clay, and dusk. So the dusk is like the darker colored one. The clay is kind of like what you would think as a clay color, like an orangey kind of tan color. And then the other ones I got are white sand and blush. Honestly, they look the exact same to me, but I got them so I could do some block printing on them and they turned out so gorgeous. You might have seen this in my last stamp making video. I put these in my shop recently and I love them so much. And then the next thing I got was some more Arches watercolor paper because I really needed more. I've been using this literally for every single painting that I do. The quality is so nice. It's just scary because it's so expensive, so I feel like if I mess up, I'm gonna be like wasting a ton of money. My grandpa is a watercolor artist and I saw that he used this over the years, so I had to like try it this past year and now I'm kind of obsessed. The other thing that's really cool about the Arches paper is that the pages are glued together, so when you are painting, a lot of the time when you do watercolors, you find that the paper kind of buckles because of all the water you're using. So the fact that it's stuck together means that it can't do that. It has to lay flat. Highly recommend if you're looking for some like really high quality watercolor paper. Okay, so the last paper product that I wanted to show you guys that you have probably seen it, I got it like a month or so ago, is these Pantone blocks. They are so cute. I love these so much. But basically it comes with 100 Pantone swatches. And what I've been doing is I take them and I do little paintings on them. And I was supposed to do a 100-day challenge. It didn't really work out. I'm just kind of doing it as I please instead. of kind of forcing myself to do it every day because I've kind of been in a weird funk lately. And the back of them actually has a little place where you can put a stamp and make it into a postcard. So I just think it's so cute. All right, so next we're going to be talking about the painting supplies that I got. I just went to Blick, I think it was like 2 weeks ago. I have been wanting these paints for so long, and I decided to treat myself and get some. These paints are by Holbein, and they are the acrylic gouache paints. They pretty much make the most aesthetically pleasing colors you could think of. I went into Blick telling myself I was only gonna get 10, and I wound up with close to 20 different tubes of these, but oh my goodness. These paints are amazing. I love them so much. These are my new babies. So the next paints that I got are some watercolors, and they are so cute. I put them in this tiny bowl because I thought it was so cute. They're the Daniel Smith Extra Fine watercolors. My two favorite watercolor brands are Winsor & Newton and Daniel Smith. I only have a couple Daniel Smith paints that I've gotten in the past though, and I love them so much, so I wanted to get some little ones. I decided to get the tiny tubes because one, they're adorable, and two, you really don't need that much watercolors. I've had tubes for like years and years, and I've never even come close to using all of it, so I decided to get the tiny ones. They're so cute! Another thing that I got from Michaels are the Artist Loft watercolor paints, and they're just basic colors that I thought would be nice to have around, because a lot of the time I get like very like particular colors when I go and buy like the fancy ones, so it's nice to just have like the basics. And I kind of wanted to try them and see like the quality, because they're literally $4. I'm gonna be using those in a video coming up, so I'll be testing that out later. There's so much stuff going on here, I can't even find what I was looking for. Oh, there it is. Okay, we're good. And the last painting supplies that I got are these brushes. I've been needing some good, like, just basic acrylic paintbrushes. I pretty much started out only doing watercolor, so I have a ton of watercolor brushes around that I keep trying to use for acrylics and then I ruin them. So I decided to get the Blick Essentials pack. Usually when I get packs of brushes, I'm not super impressed by them a lot of the time, but this one I really, really love. I would definitely recommend it if you're looking for good, like a good set of acrylic brushes. And then for the tiny brushes, which is what I needed just a really good detail brush. So I got these Blick Masterstroke Finest Red Sable ones. It's really hard to detail with acrylic, so I wanted to invest in some like nice detailing brushes. And I made sure to set them in a whole separate jar rather than putting them with my watercolor brushes so that I wouldn't be tempted to use any of my watercolor brushes while I'm doing acrylic painting. Now we are going to move on to pens, which I never get anymore because if you look at my stash of pens, it's like I have a problem. But I saw something at Target and I couldn't resist myself. I got the full set, all 25 colors. It says it's the complete collection, which I didn't even know that I had this many colors. Do you guys remember when they had like the small packs? It was like, I think it was like 8 pens, and now they're up to 25. I used to use these so much in my journal, and now all of my old ones are like dried out, so I had to get these. The only other pens that I got are super nostalgic. You guys will know these as soon as you see them. But I tell everyone, if you're starting with calligraphy or you're just wanting to like add colors to your bullet journal and don't want to spend a lot of money, these guys are so good. Like the Crayola Super Tips are really like the best way to start out. And they have like such an amazing array of colors in here. And it's $4. But yeah, those are all the pens that I got. So the next things that I wanted to show you guys are washi tapes. So the first ones that I want to show you guys are the new ones from Amanda Rach Lee that she sent me. So I believe she sent me the dark one is the dark monochrome set, light neutral set, and her little doodles washi tape set, which is super cute. I think my favorite one is the like little starry one that was in the light neutral set, but I love all of them so much. They're so cute. I love it when artists come out with washi tape. I feel like I want to design one at some point. I just wouldn't even know where to start. But another artist that I bought some washi tapes from is Jordan Clark. And I actually got these quite a while ago, but I don't know if I ever showed you guys them. They're the most aesthetically pleasing washi tapes you could imagine. I feel like all of Jordan Clark's stuff is very just aesthetically pleasing. But yeah, I got 5 different designs because I love them all. And then the last washi tapes that I got are my tried and true Scotch Expressions washi tapes. These ones come in like the prettiest colors. They also have a champagne version and a copper version, which I usually get. And for some reason, this washi tape has a much better stick on them than usual, like normal washi tapes. So I use these to package my orders and I love them so much. I will always repurchase those. I started out with my washi tape box completely empty and now it's completely full, which I love. I love when I have a full thing of full washi tapes. I'm so excited. Anyways, I get way too excited for literal tape. All right, 2 more categories. We have stickers and like little random tools that I've gotten. So I'll go for stickers first. All of these stickers I got quite a while ago and they all went missing. So I wanted to finally show you guys them. So the first pack that I got is from Softly Studio. And they make these just really minimalistic, but very like, all the colors are very soft and just elegant. I love them so much. They also have a bunch of like handmade paper and journals. I just think it's so cute. I love the style of it. Packaging also was so amazing when it first came. I also got some stuff from Hello Wildflower, and I just found the shop pretty recently. And they had this like really cute moon tarot card sticker, which I think is so adorable. Rose vinyl sticker and then the mushroom print. I just think everything's so adorable. The next stickers I got are another thing from Jordan Clark, and all of her stuff is so aesthetically pleasing. She is such an inspiration. I have like 5 different packs of her stickers. I don't know if her shop is open right now, but I know I got these like a little while ago. I'm what is known to be a sticker hoarder, so I will probably never use these stickers actually. Maybe I should make a video on Instagram like going over my full sticker collection, because I just hoard stickers from artists that I love and then never use them. So next ones though I'm totally gonna use because they're vinyl stickers, so I can probably stick them on my water bottle or something. But these ones are from a tattoo artist actually, and we actually went to high school together. She's super super talented and she made these cute Animal Crossing stickers. She made like a Celeste one and a leaf one that I just had to have because obviously I'm obsessed with Animal Crossing, if you guys couldn't tell from my Twitch streaming. And those are all the stickers that I got. The last section that I want to go over are just some random tools. There's only a couple, but this first tool is by Westkit, and it's basically just a circle template. I'm really personally bad at drawing circles, and so I personally need this in my life. I had a larger one, but I wanted to have one that's like smaller to do like tiny, tiny little circles. But yeah, this is gonna be very handy for that. And then the last tool that I got were these rulers. I actually already had this mini one, but I wanted to get a matching one. I always am needing like to make straight lines on bigger papers. But yeah, that is basically the end of this stationery haul. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I haven't done one of these in quite a long time, so I figured it was about time. And before I go, I wanted to talk a little bit about Squarespace, who is sponsoring this video today. If you've never heard of Squarespace, they're an online platform that allows you to create your own website super easily. I've been trying to make mine look very aesthetically pleasing, and they definitely give you the tools to be able to do that with different fonts, different color schemes, and their different templates that they have pre-done. I personally have their e-commerce plan, so that I can host my own shop and take advantage of their marketing tools, such as the announcement bar on the top to let people know when I have sales or different things coming to my shop. If you guys are interested in creating your own website with Squarespace, you can click the link in my description for a free trial and 10% off your first purchase.
Thank you guys again for watching this video, and I'll see you guys in the next one.